Hi everybody, welcome to NuttX channel. Today I'll explain how to use a SPI flash like this one with smart file system in NuttX. Using smart file system, you avoid the damage of your flash because it provides wear leveling. So instead of writing the same page all the time, smart file system provides an intelligent writing around the flash memory. It avoids the damage of your flash. So let's get started. Open the Linux terminal. Enter inside NuttX space, NuttX. Execute make this clean to clear previous configuration. Smart file system will use a little bit more space in your board. So watch this video explain how to unlock the hiding 64 kilobytes of flash memory. We will need to modify the linker script to use 128 kilobytes. So execute vi config stm32f103 minimum scripts ld.script. Change it to 128 kilobytes. Now we can execute tools configure.sh stm32f103 minimum / nsh. Execute make menu config to enable the SPI flash memory and the smart file system. First, we need to reduce the memory used by the NuttX. Watch this video explain how to do that, because the smart file system will use a little bit more RAM memory. I will speed up the video now. Okay, now we can select the options to get the SPI flash with smart file system working. Enter inside system types, STM32 peripheral support. Select SPI1. Enter in board selection. Select MTD driver for external 4 MB flash on SPI1. Here we have the configuration of partition list. We can change the partition size if you want. Now go to device drivers. Confirm the memory technology device MTD support is enabled, and if our flash memory is selected, okay. Now go to file systems, deselect the disable pseudo file system operations. We need the pseudo file system operation. Confirm the smart file system is enabled. We can leave now. Go to application configuration, file system utilities, and confirm the mkey smart file system utility is enabled. Now go to NSH library, go to disable individual commands, and deselect the disable mcar smart file system. We can leave again, and leave and save our configuration. Okay. Now just execute make to compile the source code. We need to connect the SPI flash in our board. I did a small fritzing schematic here, explain how to connect the SPI flash in our board. Connect the VCC to 3.3 volts. Connect the chip select to A4. Connect the data output to A6. Connect the data input to A7. Connect the SPI clock to A5. And the GND connect to ground pin or G pin in the board. Basically, that is it. We need to flash the firmware inside the board. Please watch this video explain how to do that. Open OCD, move to app. Okay, the firmware was flashed. I'm using the serial console instead the USB console because this board doesn't have memory enough to get the USB and the smart file system working at the same time. I will execute minicon, reset the board, and we got the NuttX shell. Let's see if the smart file system partition are here. Okay, it created 4 partitions, P0, P1, P2, and P3. And we have the make file system command to create the file system. So execute make smart file system, passing the name of partition, /dev/smart0p0. It delay about 1 second and format the partition. If I type mount, we see there is no partition mounted. And now we'll mount it. Mount minus t smart file system /dev/smart0p0/the mounting point, MNT in this case. Now, if I type mount again, okay, the partition was mounted. So, if we list the MNT, there is no file yet. So, let's create it. Echo testing 1, 2, 3 MNT test.txt. Execute ls again. Okay, the file was created. Let's see what is inside. Okay, it's correct. Now I will reset the board again. We need to mount the partition. Mount smartfs/dev/smart0p0/mnt. Okay, let's see. Right. That is it. I hope you had enjoyed this video and see you in the next video. Bye bye.